If there was any good news arising out of the ashes of the Texas Governor's Mansion fire 2 years ago, it is that none of the priceless antique furniture in the building was damaged. You see, at the time of the fire, it had all been removed for a planned restoration of that historic mansion. All new at 6, though, Jim Swift tells us those furnishings still needed a lot of work.
How do you do, ladies and gentlemen, and hello there, boys and girls. This is Governor W. Leo Daniel of Texas, speaking direct from his 88-year-old governor's mansion in the friendly city of Austin.
A newly opened Texas Governor's Mansion exhibit at the Bob Bullock State History Museum paints a picture of the building's past.
And say hello to all of us here in our home, sweet home.
The mansion furnishings in the exhibit are in pristine condition. But even without a fire to bother them, they weren't always that way. Their savior, it turns out, is an old boy working out of his house down in South Austin.
These drawers were not working. Everything is working. Beautiful.
For more than a decade, John Swearingen has been the go-to craftsperson for restoration work on the mansion furniture.
This piece was built around 1750 in America. It's an American piece.
The high boy chest of drawers is part of a private collection, but it makes for a good illustration of the kind of miracles Swearingen has had to perform on mansion furnishings.
We try to adhere to the code of conservation in museums is never do anything that can not be reversed.
Nothing, of course, could have more violated that code than for the mansion furniture to have been inside the building when it burned.
Man, if this stuff had been in there, what a loss. I mean, the building is bad enough, and we still have it, though, so we're good. And you can still go down and see Sam Houston's bed and see where the first child was birthed in the governor's mansion. And you can see where Stephen F. Austin sat down with his pen and quilled away at something.
Jim Swift, KXAN, Austin News.